Hi friends, this is the second lecture. In this lecture, we will explain you how many prime in a such number, okay? And if you will try to find how many zero in n factorial. Suppose someone will ask you how many zero in n factorial, then how will you find it, okay? Our motto at first, we have to find a derivative, and after that we have to put the derivative in our coding, okay? So, at first we also explained you in the previous lecture what is the definition of prime, what is the definition of natural number. Natural number means we can count, and prime means it has only two factors, one and itself. Okay. And now the third one, we told you that the natural number means we can express in this form, p to the power a, p to the power b, r to the power c, where p to r belong to prime number and a, b, c belong to natural number. Okay. And the expression, you know that 12 also we can write in this form, means 2 to the power square and 3 to the power 1, means 4 to the 12. So this is also prime, this is also prime. Similarly, 36 we have written 2 to the square and 3 to the square. It means that 9 to the 36, this is also p to the power and this is also p to the power. Okay. So every natural number we can write prime to the power. Okay. So now suppose someone will ask that how many 2 in 12? How many 2 in 12? Just I will explain you. The formula is very simple. You will write n p to the power 1 plus n p to the power square plus n p to the power 3 plus up to so on this. Suppose you have to find total number of prime. Okay. Total number of prime. Suppose you have to find total number of prime. How many 2? Okay. So you have 12. So you will use it 12 upon just. Remember that is belonging to Z. Z means integer. Okay. So this is 12 and this is P. P means 2. We are finding for 2. 2 to the power 1 plus 12 upon 2 to the square plus 12 upon 2 to the power 3 plus 12 upon 2 to the power 4. Okay. So now this question is 2 into 2 into 2 into 2. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16. So here we are getting natural number. No, so we are getting the digit number means decimal number, okay, just like 0 point something something, okay. So you will not take it. Why? Because we are, I told you that this must be belonging to Z. Z means that must be any value. 2.56, suppose you are getting, you will take this number. Leave it this number. Decimal number we will not take, okay. So that number, just leave it. Then after that, 2 to the 4 to the 8. And 12 upon 8, okay, that then we will get the Z, okay. Then 2 to the 12 plus 2 to the 4, 4 to the 12 plus 8, 1. We are taking only 1 because 1 point something we are getting. And I told you that belonging to Z. So according to this definition, we will leave the decimal part. So 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total number of 2 are 10. According to this formula, total number of 2 are 10. So now you can find total number of 2 in 12. Okay. So these are 12. And now check it. How many? Actually, we are talking about the n factorial. Number first. Remember it? N factorial. In this lecture, we are talking about n factorial. Okay. The natural number expression is this. Okay. But this lecture dedicated for factorial. Okay. N factorial. In n factorial, how many prime, how many zero, or you can calculate everything. Okay. So in 12 factorial, actually we are talking about 12 factorial. 12 factorial. Factorial meaning, what is the meaning of factorial? N factorial is equal to n into n minus 1 into n minus 2 up to so on 1. It means that 12 factorial is equal to 12 into 11 into 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. So this is the expression of 12 factorial. So how many 2 are here? You have to understand. Okay. So here, just check. 6, 4, 3 is 12. So 2 is square into 3. 4, 3 is 12. So we got 2, 2. 2 is square means we got 2, 2. Okay. And here, 5, 2 is 10. We got 1, 2. Okay. And here we got 2 to the power 3, we got 3, 2, okay. Here we got 2 into 3, we got 1, 2. And here we got 2 by square, it means that we got 1, 2, 2, and here we got 2 to the power 1. So total number of 2 are 2, okay. Here 2, 1, 2, okay. You will write 2, and 2 are 2, and 1 is 2, okay. And here 2 are 3, and here 2 is 1, and here 2 are 2, and here 2 is 1. So now count 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So total number of 2 means in 12 factorial are 10. It means that if you add, then you will get 2 to the power 10. Means it will write n factorial. Suppose again you will write, I told you that every natural number can be write in the form of this prime to the power. Okay, this is also a number n factorial, and we have written this. This is also a number. Okay, this number also can write in this form. Okay, so we will write in this form, then we will get this 2 to the power 10. Similarly, for other prime we can write. Okay, we can find also how many 3, how many 3, how many 7, how many 5 we can count. So this is a very simple formula. Suppose I will give you very simple, I am just rearranging it. Okay, suppose I will give you very simple. This is suppose 6 factorial. Okay, 6 factorial means 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, how many 2 are here? How many 3 are here? Okay, we will count. So according to this formula, at first we are finding how many 2. How many 2 means 6 upon 2 to the power 1 plus 6 upon 2 to the power square and plus 6 into 2 to the power 3. Okay, that will be not here because we are belonging to Z. So this is 2 to be 3 are 6 and 4 and 4. That is 4. So there are total number of 4 2. Okay, how? Now you can see 1 2, 2 2 and 1 2. 1, 2, 3 and 4. So there are total number of 4 2. It means that 2 to the power 4. You will get 2 to the power 4. Number first. This is the first. Now second, how many 3? Number second, how many 3? How many 3 is equal to 6 upon 3 to the power 1 plus 6 upon 3 to the power square. 3 is a 9, so it will be not here. So 3 to the 6 is 2 are, there are 2 2. It means that you will write, here, okay? 2 to the power 4 and into 3 to the power 2. Okay? We have written now. Now the third one is, we have got 2, we have got this 3, we have got 2, we have got 2. Now the last 5. How many 5? How many 5? So this is 6 upon 5 plus 6 upon 5 pi square. This will not be not because it is belonging to Z. 6 upon 5 is equal to 1. So here is only 1 5. So this 6 factorial, it will be write 2 to the power 4 into 3 to the square into 5 to the 1. So you can see that every natural number can be write prime to the power. We can see here, we have written every natural number can be write prime to the power. Okay, and we find this 6 factorial is equal to this, and after that we have written prime to the power. Okay, so that formula, it is very important, you know, by the help of this formula we can write any natural number prime to the power. You know that we have written here also 6 factorial prime to the power. Okay, so that is the basic formula. Now suppose someone will ask you that how many 0 in 100 factorial. Very simple question. Okay, how many 0 in 100 factorial? And so when I am raising it, I am thinking, you know that is the 100 factorial, that is a very very big number. We cannot write, we cannot multiply all number 100 into 99 into 98 into 97 into 96 up to so on into 2 into 1. That is a very big number. Suppose I will give you 10,000 factorial, suppose I will give you very big number. So in this situation it is not possible to solve such type of problems. So we find that some derivative. We will use the derivative by the help of this formula, means derivative. We can find the, formula, we can find the solution. Okay. So, again we will use the same process for 100 factorial. 100 factorial means total how many 0 in 100 factorial. So we get 0 by the help of 5 into 2. 5 into 2 is equal to 10. Okay, only 5 can give you the 0. Okay, if you multiply 5 to 2, then you will get 0. So we here in this problem we will find how many 5 in 100 factorial. Okay, so total number of 5s in 100 factorial will give us the exact result, that how many 0 in 100 factorial. That is very simple. So 100 upon sigma 5 is equal to 100 upon 5 to the power 1 plus 100 upon 5 square plus 100 upon 5 cube plus 100 upon 5 to the power 4 up to so on. 5 5 is 25, 25 5 is 125, so it is not possible. 5 5 25, 25 by 120, this is also not possible. And this is 100 upon 5 is equal to 5 is 10 and 0. Okay, plus this is 5 5 25, 25 4 is this, then total number of 24. So if you use any machine, means a computer, and a computer, you can put also the 100 factorial, so there will be total number of 24 0. Now there is a question, maybe I am wrong. It can possible, maybe I am wrong, it can possible. So I am using 10 factorial, very simple. Okay, so 10 factorial, how many 0? How many 0? So, okay, so we will use 10 means 10 into 9 into 8 into 7 into 6 into 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Okay, so that is a very big number. How many 0 are here? There are 2 0. 1 is 0 is like this, and 1 0 is 5 into 2. Multiply any even number, maybe 2, maybe 4, maybe any even number. You will multiply by 5, then you will get again another 0. And you have to just take this number, either take 2 number, 4 number, any even number, then you will get another 0. So there are only 2 0, we can see. By the help of this formula, we will use 10 upon 5 to the power 1 plus 10 upon 5 to the power square. 5 to the power, so this is not, it means that 5 to the 10, there are only 2 0. We can see, in 10 factorial, you can also use your computer, your calculator, and you can see how many 0, if you multiply all number, then you will get only 2 0 at last. Okay. And but by the help of this formula, and by the help of this formula we have calculated, and similarly we can calculate it for a big number, 100 factorial, 10,000 factorial, 1 crore factorial, you can use any number. Okay, we are putting such type of formula in our coding, so we are getting the exact result. Okay, the mathematician, they discover this formula, and after them the people they use, and after them they are getting the result. Okay, so I think that you got some information. In the next lecture we will explain you something that will be helpful for your exam also. If you are just preparing for GR exam, GATE exam, any exam, okay, that such type of questions also come many times. Okay, thank you so much.